What's going on, guys? Josh here from Momentum Productions, and today I'm here with the Feiyutech A2000 gimbal. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to use your gimbal as a dolly or a slider. Now, just because I'm using the Feiyutech A2000 for this video, that doesn't mean that you can't use any other brand. You can definitely apply this technique to any stabilizer you wish. So in this video, we're going to be covering three basic dolly and sliding moves. The first move incorporates more of that dolly action, so we're going to see a lot more travel compared to the other two shots in this video. The other two shots don't really have that many steps, so please pay attention to how I use my legs and my hands to get the most stable shot possible. And I'm comparing this to a dolly because with the right technique, you can actually use your gimbal as a real dolly. You can get almost exactly the same results. Now pay close attention to my foot placement, how my knees are bent, and how my body is rolled up like a ball. If you click on this video here, you'll see how I use a similar technique when I'm running with the gimbal. Why do I use this technique? Well, it allows me to incorporate more stability in my shots. You roll yourself up like a ball, and you become more sturdy and stable. Now, as you dolly in, you are taking tiny footsteps. And you're keeping your knees bent, and you're using the heel-to-toe technique. This will guarantee you stable and accurate shots. Now, this next shot is pretty unique, and I'll tell you why. Because we're kind of shooting at a low angle going up. This is specifically great for horror or suspense films because we have that weird wide angle, low angle type shot, and it's going up into a mysterious area. So with the right color grading, you can actually make this look like a horror shot. So how do I perform this technique? Again, knees are slightly bent, elbows are slightly bent, elbows are to my sides, and I put the gimbal into flashlight mode. As soon as I put the gimbal into flashlight mode, then I tilt up the camera using the joystick that's on the handle, and I'm able to get that nice low angle, wide angle type shot dollying in. Now in this shot, I'm not taking any steps at all. I'm doing one easy move with my shoulders, with my elbows. I'm just kind of leaning in. Take a look at my legs and how I'm using my legs to change my distribution of weight between one and the other. And this is how you're gonna get that nice lean in and lean out effect. Now, I don't know if you can tell in this shot, but I'm actually lifting up my elbows and shoulders as well, just so I can get that scoop. I kind of scoop the camera. I start low and I scoop towards the stairs. I hope that makes sense, but that's the kind of movement I'm incorporating in this shot. And this gets you more fluidity, more movement in your footage, and it's, again, great for those horror shots. And also, I recommend doing this in full lock mode. On the Feiyutech A2000, all you have to do is press on this trigger here, and your gimbal is completely locked. However, other gimbals enter lock mode differently, so make sure you check out your gimbal's manual in order to better understand each mode and how to enter them. If you want to learn more about these kinds of lean in and lean out effects, click on this video here where I show you exactly how to do it with a glide cam. Our last and final shot incorporates our hip. And I'll tell you how. For those of you who have a gimbal, I strongly recommend that you buy an extension tabletop tripod like this one here. I'm not a huge fan of the one that comes with the Feiyutech A2000 simply because it's plastic, it's small, and it's not that stable, especially with such a heavy setup like mine here. So with this Pergear tabletop tripod, I'm able to press it against my hip or my waist, and I'm able to get that nice, stable shot, especially when I'm trying to incorporate a sliding move. You have to be very accurate. Now, if you're shooting an inanimate object that doesn't move, then you can shoot at 60 frames per second and slow it down in post, just so you get rid of any of those up and down movements. The hip allows you to rest the gimbal and it doesn't tire you out, and it provides you that extra source of stability. So try this technique and see if it works out for you. I'm not gonna lie, it took me a few tries to get the shot right because I did end up seeing some up and down movements. So keep that in mind. And don't forget to continue keeping your elbows bent, have a strong foundation on the ground, and keep your knees bent as well. Now, using sliding moves is important when you're trying to showcase a product. You can use it as an establishing shot. So a sliding move is great for so many different sorts of shots. So in this case, I used bottles of alcohol. I shot this at 60 frames per second and slowed it down to 30 frames per second. All right guys, well I hope this tutorial on how to use your gimbal as a slider and dolly has helped you out. Please don't forget to give this video a big like, share it with your friends, and subscribe with notifications on. I will have a full review of the Feiyutech A2000 gimbal coming out shortly, so make sure you stay updated and subscribe to my channel with notifications on. Thank you guys so much for watching. I can't wait to see what you create, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.